Hi friends, my name is Nikhil and in this tutorial video I will be teaching you how to play the A.R. Rahman hit song Singappenney. This tutorial was requested by one of my students and I'm very happy to bring this video to all of you. I hope you learn to play the song after watching this video. If you face any difficulties, please feel free to comment below and let me know which areas you have difficulty with. I would like to help you out with them. Now, about the song, I really enjoyed learning the song and I found it to be a simple song which was made wonderfully complex. There are 7 chords which are used in the song, and if you look at the top right hand of your screen, you can see them one by one. The first chord is an E chord, and this is how you play the E chord. Do watch my tutorial video on how to read chord diagrams if you have difficulty playing these chords. The second chord is the A chord. The third is the A minor chord. The fourth one is the B chord. The fifth is the C sharp minor chord. Number 6 is your F sharp minor chord, and number 7 is your G sharp minor chord. So feel free to pause the video and have a look at the chord diagrams over here if you aren't sure how to play these chords. You can also look at my existing tutorial videos on how to play each of these individual chords. You should find them there. There are many verses in the song, many of which are repetitions. So you may find a lot of similarity between different verses. But to make things easy for you, I will be covering each and every verse of the song. So be sure to stick with me throughout the video. And if you find any part of the song difficult, do rewind and watch that section again. I'm sure you will be able to get it. So let us start with the song now. I'm first going to be looking at the intro. This is how it sounds like. Now, the intro has 2 lines, each line being played twice, for example. Now, the intro, which I have labeled 1A, is going to be a B chord, followed by an A chord, followed by an E chord for the first line. The second line will be again a B followed by an A followed by an E. Let's see how this sounds like with the correct timing. B A E B A E. Moving on to section 1B. Section 1B has the E chord played in this fashion. This is how section 1B sounds like. Now let me take you through section 1B line by line. The first line has a number of E chords played one after the other. But played in this manner. Then we go to an A chord, and finally we close with an E chord for section 1B. Let's see how section 1B sounds like with the correct timing. First, we play an E chord. A. E. Now we move to section 1C. In 1C, let us first listen to how it sounds. And this is how the individual chords sound. We have three chords here, an A, followed by a B, followed by a C sharp minor. Let's look at how it sounds like with the right timing. A, B, C sharp minor. That's how it sounds like. Moving on to the next section. It is verse 1A. This is how verse 1A sounds like. Listen to it once. கீரங்கள் துடிபோடு பாதங்கள் திவிரோடு சீரங்கள் வாரங்கள் வாரங்கள். And now let me take you through it line by line. The first line, we have an A chord, which then we move into an E. The second line, we have an A chord, and then we go to a C sharp minor, and follow it up with an E. The third line, we go to an E, and then to an A. The fourth line, we play an E again. And the last line, we again play an E. But let's play that with the right timing. E, A again, C sharp minor, E, E, A, E, E. Now we go to 1B, section 1B or verse 1B. In verse 1B, let us first listen to how it sounds like. கோலங்கள் இதுமங்கள் காலம் இனிமேல் உலகம் பார்க்க போகுது மனிதன். Now let us look at the chords. The first line has an A chord. The second line goes to a B chord. The third line goes back to an E chord. Let's see how it sounds like when you play with the right timing. A, B, E. Now we move on to the interlude number 1. Let's listen to how it sounds like. Now let me take you through this line by line. So we start off with an E chord, which we play like this. Next we play an A chord, and then we play a B chord. Let's see how this sounds with the correct timing. E, A, B. Now we move on to the next section. Let's listen to what it sounds like. Singappenney, Singappenney. Let me take you through this line by line. The first line has an E chord. The second line has an A chord followed by a B chord. The third line takes you to a C sharp minor followed by an A chord. The next line has a C sharp minor, a B. So let's see how this sounds with the right timing. E, E, A, B, C sharp minor, A, C sharp minor, B. Moving to verse 2b now, let's listen to how it sounds. Now let me take you through the chords. The first line has an E chord. The second line also has an E chord. The third line has a B chord. So let's see how this sounds like with the right timing. E, E, B. Now we go to the next verse, verse 3a. Let's listen to how it sounds like. And let me walk you through the chords. The first line has an E chord. The second line also has an E chord. E chord for the first line. E chord for the second line. A B chord for the third line. And an A chord for the last line, which is followed by an E. So let's see how it sounds like with the right timing. A, back to E. Moving on to verse 3b, let's listen to how it sounds like. Let me walk you through the chords. The chords for verse 3b are exactly the same as for 3a. So the first two lines are going to be E. Third line is going to be a B chord. The last line is an A chord followed by an E. So let's play it together. So let's listen to what it sounds like with the right timing. E, B, A, E. Go to verse 4 now. Let's listen to how it sounds. Now, let me walk you through the chords. The first line has an E chord. The second line has an E chord as well. The third line has an E, A, followed by an E chord. The next line has an F sharp minor. And the last line has a B chord. So let's play that with the right timing. Let's start now. E, E, A, E, F sharp minor. Now we move to verse number 5. Let's listen to what it sounds like. Let's look at the chords in verse number 5. We have an E chord for the first two lines, a B chord for the third line. So So E chord for the first two lines, a B chord for the third line, and the last line has an A chord followed by an E chord. Let's play this with the right timing. E, E, B, A, back to E. Let's go to verse number 6. Verse number 6. Let us listen to verse number 6 now. That's how it sounds like. Let me walk you through the chords. The first two lines of verse number 6 have an E chord. Line number 3 has a B chord. Line number 4 has an A followed by an E. Let's play this with the right timing now. E, E, B, A, E. I would suggest skipping the interlude number 2 because it has a large number of drum beats which cannot be replicated easily with your guitar. So I would suggest skipping this. If you do want to play it, you should play an E chord and sing along and quickly move to the next section. Verse number 7A. Let's listen to what it sounds like. Now let us cover the chords in verse 7a. The first three lines have a B chord. The last line ends with an E chord. Let's play this with the right timing. B, 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 E. Moving on to verse 7b, let's listen to how it sounds like. Let me walk you through the chords. The first three lines have a B chord and we end on an E chord for the fourth line. So let's play it along with the right timing. B, 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 E. Now let's move to verse 7C. The whole verse can be played with just one chord, an E chord. Let's listen to what it sounds like. Let me walk you through the chords for this verse 7C. The whole verse can be played with just the E chord. Let's play this with the right timing now. Now let's go to verse number 8A. Verse number 8A sounds like this. Through the chords. The first line has an E chord, the second line goes to a G sharp minor followed by an A, the third line has a C sharp minor, and the fourth line has an E chord again. Let's play this with the right timing. E, G sharp minor, A, C sharp minor, back to an E. Let us go to verse 8b now. Let's listen to how it sounds like. for this. The chords are E for the first line, second line a D sharp minor which goes to an A, the third line continues on A, and the last line we still keep playing the A. So let us play this with the right timing. D sharp minor, back to an A, 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 A. Now let us go to verse 9a. Let's listen to how it sounds. Now let me walk you through the chords. The first two lines of 9a have an E chord. The third line we move to a B chord. And the last line we play an A chord followed by an E chord. Let's play this with the right timing. E, B, B, A, back to an E. Moving on to verse 9b. This is an exact repetition of 9a. So I'm going to play this for you. E, E, B, B, A, E. Moving on to interlude number 3. Let's listen to how it sounds. Now let me walk you through the chords. So we have a transition here, which is a bit tricky, but just follow along and you can do it. The chords here are E, A, B, A, followed by C sharp minor, B, E, B, after which we have the female vocals joining in. So for the second line we have an E, A, B, A, again a C sharp minor, B, E, B, and for the last part of interlude 3 we have A, C sharp minor, B, E, A. Let's see how this sounds like with the right timing. E, A, B, A, C sharp minor, B, E, B, E, A, B, A, C sharp minor, B, E, B, A, C sharp minor, B, E, A. Now let's move to verse number 10. Let's listen to how it sounds like. Now let me walk you through the chords for this, verse number 10. The first line has a B followed by an E, again a B, and then an E. The second line goes to an A followed by an E. The third line has an F sharp minor followed by an E, then an A. The fourth line has an E followed by a B followed by an E for the fifth line. The fifth line has an E followed by an A followed by an A minor. The last line has an E followed by a B. So let's play this with the right timing. B, E, B, E, A, E, F sharp minor, E, A, E, B, E, A minor, E to a B. Going to verse number 11, let us listen to how it sounds like.
Singappenney, Singappenney.
Let me walk you through the chords. The first two lines have an E chord. The third line has an A chord followed by a B chord. The next line has a C sharp minor followed by an A. And the last line of verse number 11 has a C sharp minor followed by a B. Let's play this with the right timing. E, A, B, C sharp minor, A, C sharp minor, B. Let us go to verse number 12. Let's listen to what it sounds like.
Na 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 na, na 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 na, na 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 na.
Let me walk you through the chords. So, for verse number 12, we only play the E chord all throughout. Line 1, 2 and 3, we play the E chord. Let's see how this sounds like with the correct timing. Now let us go to verse number 13. Let's listen to what it sounds like. Let me play this for you. I'm not going to walk through the chords of each line because it is just a repetition of the previous verses. I'm going to play this for you. E, E, B, A, back to E. Going to verse number 14. This is the last part of the song. Let's listen to how it sounds like. And now, let me walk you through the chords. The first line has the E chord all through. The second line also has an E chord all through. The third line, we have a B chord. The last three lines, you have to pay close attention. We stop playing the guitar and then we do a muted strum. You mute the strings and you mute up and down with the right hand. The last line is ended on an E chord. Let me play this for you with the right timing. E, E, B, muted, muted, back to E.
Bigil, Singappenney.
Thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned how to play this song. If you found this a bit difficult, do come back and try it again after some time. Remember to comment, like and subscribe for more videos and walkthroughs of popular songs. Do let me know which songs you would like me to cover and I'll be happy to do them. Looking forward to hearing from all of you. Feel free to leave any requests in the comment section below. I will be happy to cover them. Thank you.